Hello and welcome back to Lumosity. Are you ready? Or not? You are either one and the other. Both, as far as I'm concerned, at the moment, hasn't been decided yet. After all, it's way in advance before you see this. So you are both ready and not ready. Right now. And you know how I feel about that? I feel great about that. Oh yes, I feel great. All with my 6 hours sleep in that. But it was twice almost the last night's sleep. The night before last sleep. So I'm feeling so good. You have no idea how good I'm feeling. No idea.
I've got an idea.
No, you don't. I feel great.
You just gave us the idea, though. How are we not supposed to know now? You just let it hold us.
You've got no idea. None at all. Not even a smattering of an idea. Not even a hint. A wisp. A synonym of that. No idea.
Okay, I see. Why don't you go and talk about your history, you stupid history teacher, aspiring human? I hate humans.
History, eh? If history is what you want, history is what you will get, soon as I can think of it. All right, make it up, rather. I didn't mean to look there! Oh, God, so embarrassing! I didn't mean to click there! That didn't matter. Did matter, I wouldn't have feels otherwise. But what matter does it make? If I focus upon my errors, I am doomed to make more. Fact! This is a game of focus. A game of feeling good. You feel good, you don't mind the fear. You do better, or at least I do. You might. I don't know how your brain works, but I know how mine works, and the more awesome I'm feeling, the more awesome I am. And I think that's just awesome.
I don't.
Right. Well, anyway. The history. I digress. The history. Okay, Doc, so what topic for today shall we cover? We already got the Mongols conquering the whole known China. We got Alexander making the world his oyster, literally. We have got the, Do we have Cleopatra yet? Do we? I think not. Unacceptable! We are now going to discuss Cleopatra. Alright, so, first of all, does anyone here know who Cleopatra was?
And that's why we're listening. Well, everybody else. No one is listening. Hell no, she won't know. Oh my!
Yes, you woe my indeed! You just... Oh my... What? Alright, Cleopatra. So, Cleopatra was... In all outward respects... Well, I'm just going to quote or paraphrase Julius Caesar here. She was charming. Most charming. Not mostly like
She's charming, but you know, she's not really. He's somewhere.
No, most charming means most, like, as in most charming of all. Anyone. Anyway, Julius Caesar was charmed indeed. So he was all like, yeah, Cleopatra, you can have this thing that you wanted and that thing out. Yeah, sure, why not? And then so she got that thing she wanted and that other thing and that other thing. Yes, and then she was ruler of Egypt. For a time. Greek, though, obviously Greek. She wasn't Egyptian. Egyptian? What? Egyptian ruling Egypt? No. No, not in those times. The Greeks had taken over. You know, we're talking Roman times now. Things have changed. Rome rules the whole world, and Greeks is part of Rome. And Egypt's also part of Rome. But let Egypt run themselves? No. No. Especially since the Greeks were responsible for giving the Romans, by the Romans taking it by force, of course, most of their technology. I mean, sure, the Romans invented the ballista. Okay, so they knew how to fight war better than anybody else. All right, their republic was their idea. And then Julius Caesar came and ruined all that, and that's the time we're at. The fall of the Roman Republic. Happened after that, I think, this Cleopatra story. In any case. No, that couldn't have been after that, because after that would have meant Julius Caesar was dead. Okay, before that. Well, during that. Let's just say during. I think it's during. All right, well, during the whole fall of Rome thing. Wait, this is not the fall of Rome. This is the rise of Rome. Okay, during the whole rise of Rome, fall of republic and democracy, all that stuff. During that time, and Cleopatra's all like, yes, yes, I'm charming. And Julius Caesar's like, yeah, yeah, take whatever you want. And so she does, and, you know, it's all grand and dandy, and BOOM! Julius Caesar gets killed by his closest associates. Possibly his half-brother Brutus, illegitimate, of course. It all was then, those days, pretty much. And, some other guys, then they're all like, you've taken too much power, Julius. It's the last straw, bud. We're no longer buds. On Facebook, we are no longer friends.
No longer friends! I loathe you, brother!
And so they were no longer friends on Facebook. And as you can imagine, Julius Caesar was crushed. And then his heart was crushed because a knife was stabbed through it. Ouch. Ouch. So, yep, there you go. That's Julius Caesar. The side story for today. Ah! Uh-huh. That's it. So, what is left to pick up the pieces? Well, there's Mark Antony, who is one of Julius Caesar. Well, I think he was actually Julius Caesar's greatest general. And then there was this guy who called himself, oh, hello there, thing I need to cut out. Oh, hello. Oh, that's just wonderful. Yes, yes, editing. Oh, I just love it. Oh, you know how much I love editing people's sensitive private information out of video? Oh, man. I love it almost as much as candy and cookie. Oh, yes, cookie. We can't forget the cookies. But then right up there, you know what? It's... Oh, man. This is so bad. All right, well, if there's one thing I can do at it, it's not failing to tell you a true story of true history. Maybe. We'll just continue. Hope I'm not spewing inaccurate facts everywhere.
I think I just spewed one. Are you gonna clean that up?
Nope. Alrighty then. So, yes. I'm, Cleopatra. She sides, I think. It's Mark Antony.
I don't remember.
Okay, she obviously doesn't side with Augustus Caesar, so let's just say it's Mark Antony. Anyway, Mark Antony is all like, lost, because Augustus Caesar's like the best guy who ever ruled Rome. He's the first emperor. King. Caesar! There we go! Augustus Caesar, yes. Yes, how could I forget? Caesar! Right. Right. So yes, he's pretty much a military genius. I think he's what? Is he Julius Caesar's nephew? I do believe. They say that Augustus Caesar turned Rome, a city of bricks, into a city of marble. That's what they say. I'm quoting somebody who said that's what they said. All right, that's what I'm saying here. And anyway, I don't know if that's true or not. I do know that it is true, mostly, that there was not much marble before, and he put some marble in, and also Rome was before a pretty minor power in the world, as in, you know, it conquered half of it, and then after Caesar, it was ruling everything, except Persia. But anyway, Cleopatra loses, Mark Antony loses, and then Cleopatra supposedly commits suicide. But see, she didn't, because it was only recorded that she committed suicide 100 years after the fact, which means that's inaccurate. Maybe, perhaps, we have no idea really, but maybe. And her personality profile, as recorded in other texts, makes it deemable by current specialist psychiatrists that she did not do it.
Not guilty of committing suicide in the first degree.
Well, anyway, I say to you,
the end of the episode has been reached. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.